Get ready to rock the streets in bold aesthetics because Filipino fashion designer Ralph Rovero gives us the ultimate fashion statement. This next generation menswear designer is skyrocketing in the fashion industry for his unique style and striking designs that are definitely eye-catching. During the recently conducted Philippine Fashion Gala, Ralph launched his newest dapper menswear collection for the whole world to see.
I really have a sportswear aesthetic. I like my clothes to be quite relaxed and comfortable. I really like to play around with different colors, play around with different shapes. I'm very much obsessed with geometrical shapes and lines and symmetries. I think this collection in particular, it's very bold and very directional with color. I'm a designer that isn't really afraid to use brighter colors or contrasting colors to create a very strong visual impact. I studied fashion design menswear at Westminster University. I started working in the fashion industry even when I was still in college. I worked with different labels in London, and through that I was able to work with other creative people in the industry, such as photographers and stylists.
Since then, Ralph has been getting a lot of attention in the fashion scene, and his designs have been featured in different big publications, including GQ Style and Vogue. So, what's next for Ralph Rovero?
I think you can expect quite a consistent design sensibility from me. I'm already working on my next collection, and also working on the marketing and the different collaborations that I have in the coming months. I want to be remembered for offering diversity to the fashion industry and for offering lifestyle staples for guys. Like, you know, I want to design clothes that people come to again and again, and they wear it day in and day out and make it their own.
Just like his designs, Ralph Rovero proves that he is two things, unique and bold. Bags speak louder than words, and Filipina designer Martha Rodriguez proves just that. This up-and-coming bag designer showcases the beauty of the Philippine textile industry, one weave at a time.
I don't see myself as a fashion designer. I'm more like a creator slash somebody who wants just to make something out of the fabrics from Mindanao. I mix the old, which is the traditional fabrics, to the new ones, which is like different materials. We have the mother pearl, you have the metals, you have the leather. I want people to see that this is a lot of beautiful fabrics that we can do and make it into very high-end designer bags that you can use. I grew up in Tungay de Oro, so it's a very small town in Mindanao. I took fashion design, clothing technology in UP, and then worked for different brands in luxury fashion houses in the Philippines. And then I decided that I want to stick to my roots, to who I am, and design or make or help the weavers exit poverty. When it started, it was just me by myself. I was a one-woman team. I do the pricing, I do the sketching, I do the packaging. But then now I have a team. I consult with the weavers and tell them like which one is better. So it's more like all the ideas coming into life, brainstorming with the designers, with the artisans, and then just carefully crafting it into the idea that it should be beautifully placed as well.
Starting from the promised land of the Philippines, Martha is now going global as her bags reach the hands of the ladies in London.
This is one of the first programs under the embassy preview, so we were the first brand to showcase it. It's more like me bringing the beauty of the Mindanao fabrics to London, showcasing it, showing to the world. I feel very optimistic about the brand, not just in London, but in all parts of the world. We are a brand for somebody who wants to really stand out. She has this bag that's very different from the others. Like, she doesn't care about brand logo. She loves to have something that has a story behind it, like a piece that can start a conversation. Where did you get the bag from? How it's being made? So she can relate to that.
Martha definitely bagged the international scene with her designs that pay tribute to the cultural heritage of Mindanao.